Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Forum in Jonesboro, Arkansas. My name is Chris Champion of New Day Christian Distributors. It's a pleasure to have you here tonight. I want to tell you, about 4 years ago, there was a new group formed in gospel music that just took the whole industry by storm. Their very first record went all the way to number one in the national charts. But you know, the number one songs and the recognition isn't what's important to this group. It's seeing one more lost soul come to know the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ, and that's what makes it all right for them. And they're here tonight. They had the choice of going anywhere in the United States to make their new video to start off their fourth year in gospel music. And I'm proud to say they chose the Forum in Jonesboro, Arkansas to come and do this tonight. So would you please help me in welcoming some of the greatest guys in gospel music? I'm talking about Kevin, Robbie, Jeff, Mike, Mark, Dale, and Danny. Let's hear it for Perfect Heart.
Living water that's flowing in my soul. spirit cries out for more. Just have a little drink of this living water that flows from the heavenless shore. Now I was lost and lonely, and my spirit was right.
Happiness I found in these earthly treasures, for they could not satisfy.
But there's joy in serving my Jesus, since he's cleansed and he made me whole. And just a little drink of this living water quenches the thirsty in my soul. Oh, Jesus is the living water that's flowing in my soul. When he came into my life, how the rivers of joy did flow. When your soul is thirsty, spirit cries out for more. Just have a little drink of this living water. Have a little drink of this living water. Just a little drink of this living water that flows from the heavenly shore. Jesus is the living water that's flowing in my soul. When he came into my life, how the rivers of joy.
And with that rod stretched over the water, he made the sea turn into the dry land.
If he used sticks and stones and dead men's bones, then my God can use you.
He took 5 loaves of bread and 10,000 were fed. 12 baskets were left when they were through. My God can use you.
My God can use you.
testify. Jesus still says he delivers and heals.
In the days when he walked on earth, preaching and healing the lame, he knew the day would come to pass when he would make a change. But before he ascended to the heavens, he told his disciples to go tell it to every congregation through all generations. I still save, I deliver and heal.
Jesus still saves, he delivers and heals.
Modern day time, people say they don't need him. And to this world, he's just a myth when they say how he died to save them. But the people of God must stand up with zeal, go tell it to the flatlands and hills, to every city, to every village, that Jesus still saves, he delivers and heals.
Jesus still saves, he delivers and heals. Go tell it, everybody, salvation's still real. Don't be a statue, go testify. Jesus still saves, he delivers and heals. Jesus still saves, he delivers and heals. Go tell it, everybody, salvation's still real. Don't be a statue, go testify. Jesus still saves.
Jesus still saves and he still heals. You know what? We stood out here a while ago and there were some jokes made and everything, and we talk about our president. You know what? We need to pray for our leaders. Pray for our country. More so now than ever. And let this world know that there's still hope and there's peace in knowing Jesus Christ, and that he can still save. And how many know tonight that Jesus is still in the saving business? Amen. If you're in this building and you don't know the Jesus that we're singing about, Jesus can save you this very moment. In the days of modern day time, people say they don't need him. And to this world, he's just a myth when they tell how he died to save them. But the people of God stand up with zeal, go tell it to the flatlands and hills, to every city, to every village, that Jesus still saves, he delivers and heals.
Jesus still saves, he delivers and heals. Go tell it, everybody, salvation's still real. Don't be a statue, go testify. Jesus still saves, he delivers.
Thank God we can still have that promise. And we know that there is hope and peace. And let me say something about the Ministry of Perfect Heart. A little over 3 years now, God has allowed us to see 259 people come to know Jesus Christ as their personal Savior. And we give God all the praise for that. And you know what? We, Perfect Heart, we like to take a stand for what we feel is right. And God and what we feel and what he's done in our life and what he can do in your life, as far as I'm concerned, that's the only right. And I don't know how you feel, but I feel like we as God's people
Down through the last few years, our rights have been offended. The devil's tried his best to steal our joy and our peace and our happiness and what we stand for. I want to tell you something. We've taken something upon ourselves, and we want you to pray about this. Next spring, Lord willing, we're going to Washington, and we're going to go over there, and we're taking some petitions with us. And folks, we're going to fight to get Bible reading and prayer put back in our public schools. We're going to fight so hard. I say this everywhere we go. You know, our children, they need us. They need us to do something. But what does the future hold for them? It's time that we put back what the devil stole from us back in 1963. You listen to a song that God gave Mark Lanier, our baritone singer. The least we can do for our children is to put prayer back and Bible reading in our public schools. Listen.
We've let something happen. Was decided by a few.
Now where is all our freedom gone? We can't even pray in school.
What about our children? What will they become?
Will their living legacies forget where they've come from?
If we only take a stand,
will you fight the battle? Will you join the fight? It's time we Christians let them know that we stand for what is right. Let's
I know that makes Mark feel so good, and we appreciate Mark. He's written a lot of great songs, but I tell you what, I thank God for a songwriter that is so sensitive to the needs that are around us. And Mark, I appreciate you so much. Are you glad to see Jeff and David and Robbie and Kevin? Are you glad to see these guys tonight? Let them know it.
That's okay. I'll tell you what I want to do. This is a little unusual, and I don't know if Jeff want to do this or not, but I know we're doing a video. But I think since we're not going to be back here, and Christmas is going to be soon. Yeah. Well, I'm really hesitant about doing this, but no, I'm going to do it anyway. Why don't y'all play a Christmas song?
Sure.
Can y'all do that? Would y'all like to hear these guys play a Christmas song? Will that be all right? Let's do that. Yeah, David, Robin, Kevin. Okay, that's enough. I'll tell you what, let's do an a cappella song. Guys, let's do one. Come here. we want to do an a cappella song for you. Okay, all right. Y'all like a cappella stuff, don't you? You enjoy that, okay? All right. Let's do a song. Now, listen, in the chorus, when we picked this song, we didn't realize that in the chorus, the parts go every which way, okay?
but we're going to try to do it anyway, and we can do it if we don't get it too fast. So, Kevin, you kind of get us started there, but not too fast. And give us the key there, Jeff, and we're going to do an a cappella song.
Christ is coming back to reign upon the earth again.
The saints are looking
for the morning by and by.
By the morning
we will have no saving, then no sorrows, tears, or pain.
Bring God,
the morning,
the sweet crosses,
the easter sky.
Oh, happy day,
when the golden morning moon is on the sky.
And as
well as
the world
is falling, well goodbye.
Oh, hallelujah.
Saints are here, we're caught up in the air.
When the morning
sweet crosses, crosses,
to interrupt, Lord knows I wouldn't want to interrupt such a wonderful a cappella song, but we took a vote. We think it's way too slow.
I'll be in the rapture with the ones who are set free.
The saints
are looking for the morning by and by. What a happy meeting, what a mighty jubilee.
When morning
goes to morning, she's
recrossing the
sky. Oh, happy day, when morning goes to the sky.
As when the
sun is getting by.
Oh, hallelujah.
Saints stand on here, or we'll fly away in the air.
When morning sweeps
across
the eastern sky. Oh, happy day,
when morning goes to the sky.
As
when
this
world is gone, it's getting by. When morning sweeps across the eastern sky.
You forgot the words.
Oh, Mark.
Well, I'm looking forward.
I'd like to vote next time.
Yeah, I would too. I think I'd like to vote. No, but I'm looking forward to the day when Jesus Christ will split the eastern skies. And we who are saved, bought by the precious blood of the Lamb on Calvary, will be able to be called up together to meet him in the air. And you know I'd like to see precious loved ones that's gone on. But you know, tonight, I'd like to see my Savior, the one who bled and died on Calvary, that we can have salvation tonight. Sooner toils will be ended, and I'll stand on that shore. I will never have a heartache. Death and pain will be no more. But still greater will be to hear my Savior say, enter into the joys of heaven, for the price has been paid. When he calls my name in glory on that day, wonderful name.
will see my precious loved ones on that beautiful shore. But still greater, I'll see my Savior, and he'll open heaven's door. And oh, what joy will there await me as I cross death's chilling tide, and he'll say unto them, enter in, my child, for the blood has been applied.
Of his angels far away. the Peter threw the light. His chains all fell away, and as the light shone all the
night, Saint Peter gets his shoes. Follow me, I'll lead you high.
I'll lead you high.
Now we have
angels unaware, watching for us everywhere, sent down from God the Father just to keep us in His care. So remember when you're tempted to step into Satan's snare. Watching for us everywhere, they're sent down from God the Father just to keep us in His care. So remember when you're tempted, is it in the Satan's snare? We are guarded by the presence of His angels unaware. So remember when you're tempted, is it in the Satan's snare?
I'm so glad that those angels are all around us to watch over us and protect us. And when I leave home, I disperse those angels around my family and plead the blood of Jesus Christ over them, and I know they're saved. I'm so glad that I'm saved tonight. No, beyond a shadow of a doubt, if I should leave tonight, I'd be gone on to be with the Lord. And don't have a thing to worry about. My family's ready to go, and I'll meet them in the air if that's the way I go. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I was born and raised over in a little town called Elizabethton, Tennessee, and my mom and daddy raised 11 boys and 5 girls over there. And your mama went, daddy come home from work and say, "Who's that?" I guess he's hoping it's a neighbor's kid or something. But each one of us have fond memories of growing up, and I love the way I was raised. I loved going to Grandma's house, and if this was my favorite part, we'd all pile up in a little old car, and Daddy'd always buy 2 or 3 watermelons. And we, his Volkswagen, we all packed in it. But no, it's an old Plymouth, and if Grandma knew we were coming, she'd be out on the front porch. And they lived down in a little holler, and we had to climb a big old hill, and we'd jump out of the car just about before it stopped, you know, and we'd take off a racing toward Grandma, and we'd run down an old clay bank and race and trip one another, and they'd be youngins rolling all over the hillside, and we'd jump on the porch, and Grandma'd fuss a little bit, and she'd dust you off. And you remember how Grandma used to smush up your face and kiss you right in the mouth? It doesn't matter how do you... Huh?
I used to hate that. My grandma dipped snuff.
I don't believe I'd have told that, Mark. I see Mark with big old snuff prints all over his face. Oh, you've earned me. Where to help me, Lord? Grandpa was a cripple, man.
What's funny about that?
I'm not laughing because he's crippled. Grandpa always sat in the living room, and when Grandma would get through loving on us, he'd holler, "Come here, boy." And We'd go to running over to him, and he'd grab you by the head and shake you and love on you. And I was his favorite for the longest of time. Grandpa. Oh, there's some of you out here, your grandpa really loved you, didn't he? Hey, bald heads all over the... Huh? Why, they know they don't have any hair. Oh, let me say this. I love talking about home, and here's one thing that I'm really going to appreciate about heaven more than anything. There's going to be more than two bedrooms. Hallelujah. There's going to be more than two beds, praise God. Yeah, there's three of us boys at the top and three at the bottom. All you could jam in between. I knew what a waterbed was a long time before them things ever came out. And I mean, you get up in the morning, the sun is shining through the window, there's a rainbow right there. Oh, I was kidding about the rainbow. It wasn't there. But, I lived the waterbed part. I really did. But if I could get serious, it's going to be hard to do, ain't it? But we lived in an old house, and my mama, bless her heart, she's gone on to be with the Lord, and my daddy has too. And I can remember the times where it'd be a cold winter and we lived in an old house. It wasn't much, but it was home. Mama can make a home out of an old barn. She can make a home out of anything. She just had that touch. And you know, when you didn't have a whole lot, she could make things so special. And I miss my mama. But I know mama's in heaven. There's no doubt about that. And I remember the cold winter nights. She'd come upstairs and she'd love on us before she put us to bed, and she'd say, "All right, now get in a position you want to sleep." And she'd put cover about that thick on you. And I'll never forget the look on my mama's face as she'd love each one of us and tell us that mama loves you. It's something that you can't explain, the look in her eyes. And you know, I always wanted to buy or build my mom and dad a home, and I never got to do that. Time didn't permit. But the Lord said, "I go away to prepare you a place." And I can't help but believe that as mom and daddy went across, he put his arms around him and said, "I hold a clear title to a mansion. It's made out to you, paid in full. I want you to listen to this beautiful old song, I Hold a Clear Title."
Talk about heaven and describe its beauty so rare. So one day I purchased a title to a mansion in that land so fair. It was given to me without money, but it cost my dear Savior his life. He died on the cross just to save me. For me, the dear prize. Now I hold a clear title to a mansion that Jesus has come to prepare. And fire cannot touch it, floods cannot harm it, and it never will need a repair. The termites can mar its foundation, for on the rock of ages it stands. I feel that it's almost completed and ready for me to move in. My deed was both signed and recorded the day Jesus saved me from sin. And my name was engraved in gold letters in the Lamb's Book of Life, safe within. I'm an heir to a mansion in glory. When from this vain world here I roam, I'm waiting for Jesus to call me. I'll lay down my cross and go home. Now I hold a clear title to a mansion
Folks, I'm so glad that all down through Jesus' life, everywhere he went, he did miracles. I'm so glad that when I went to him and I needed a miracle, he did it for me. I'm so glad he went away to prepare me a mansion. And all he used to build this mansion with is two pieces of wood. And three nails. I was guilty with nothing to say, and they were coming to take me away. But then a voice from heaven was heard that said, let him go and take me instead. And I should have been crucified. See, all this pain, it should have been mine. Those rusty nails were meant just for me, but he took them and he let
suffer and die. thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has
done. A lot of things that we can give thanks for. The precious, precious blood that Jesus shed for us. We never one time think of the brutality and the hurt that our Lord went through. How the flesh was hanging off of His body. How His knees were all busted up and bruised as He fell beneath the weight of the cross. Beneath the weight of the sins of this world. So as the holy, precious Lord bled and died there on Calvary, He was thinking of the times that you were going to call on His name. He was thinking of the times that your children may be sick. He was thinking of the times that Satan was bringing depression upon you. And He said in His holy word that we can boldly come before the throne of God and ask anything, anything in His name. So even in our problems as Christians, we can give thanks unto the Lord, and He can come down and move mountains out of our way because we praise Him even though we're in trouble. That's what he longs to hear. My brothers and my sister. So as Danny leads us in this chorus, whatever the need is in your life, give thanks unto the Lord for it.
Sing with us.
Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks, for He has given Jesus Christ. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks, for He has given Jesus Christ, His Son.
Truly, we are winners tonight. Through the blood of Jesus, we're all winners. Amen.
Curled up in their prison cell, they shivered in the cold, tortured for the cause of Christ.
yet peace was in their souls. For weeks they were in shackles that cut their hands and feet. The horror of a Roman jail for preaching in the streets. Then suddenly the soldiers came and grabbed one of the brothers. He knew that death was waiting out that door, yet he called out to the others. Our great Lord, and at times it seems they might succeed as we face their vengeful source. But like those Christian brothers who offered up their lives, they were boldly pledged to fight on as we press toward the prize. Those Satan hurls with all his might his massive fury against us. We cannot prevail, he's doomed to fail before the power of Jesus. We have won, we have won. Through the blood of Jesus, we have won. It will ring out.
Right here with me, okay?
I've heard an old, old story, how the Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary to save a wretch like me.
much. And did you enjoy the guys tonight? Let them know it. How about it for Mike and Mark and Dale? Jeff, David.